In June this year, the East African Legislative Assembly passed budget estimates of $103 million for the East African Community for the financial year 2023-2024, but the budget has remained unimplemented up to October after Tanzania and Democratic Republic of Congo refused to assent to it.
One is the delay in the implementation of the budget. The budget has a lifetime. So every financial year we pass a budget, and that budget is implemented by the organs and institutions of the community.
Appearing before the Parliamentary Committee of East African Affairs, Uganda's representative to the East African Legislative Assembly, led by George Odongo, noted that operations of the East African Community have been at the shutdown for 3 months with no money to run the federation.
So the delay in the passing of the budget means that the activities of the assembly, of court, and the other institutions of the EAC have been delayed for almost 3 months now, because the budget is supposed to be implemented from 1st of July.
East African Legislative Assembly representatives noted that they have spent 3 months home with no business, plus other EAC organs like the East African Court of Justice that have not transacted business this time.
Going to, for instance, the court is not sick. The East African Court of Justice does not sit. There are a lot of cases. I also have my own case for interpretation, basically on the powers of the treaty, because we need the interpretation about where are the powers of the Council of Ministers vis-a-vis the powers of the members of Parliament or the Assembly in terms of determining the budget.
Tanzania and the Democratic Republic of Congo accused the East African Legislative Assembly of overstepping its mandate by passing the $103 million budget, which is above the ceiling of the $97 million earlier approved by the Council of Ministers. But Ugandan legislators claim Tanzania and DR Congo were asked by the East African Legislative Assembly rejection of the budget to procure language translation equipment.
It was rejected by the partner states. And, you know, we are also challenging the process on rejection, because rejecting to assent on the bill is the role of the presidents. But who rejected, who signed the rejection or the refusal is the ministers.
Now, the leader of Uganda's delegation to the East African Legislative Assembly, George Odongo, has vowed to petition the East African Court of Justice, seeking interpretation on the powers of East African Legislative Assembly over EAC budget. They also want the East African Treaty to be amended and modified to suit the politics of the time, saying it was promulgated before several partner states joined the community.
That we would want the court to interpret provisions of the treaty that empowers the East African Legislative Assembly, in the passing of the budget.
But we have passed the budget as a temporal measure, but we are also seeking for the interpretation of the East African Court of Justice in terms of the areas on the powers of the Council versus the powers and the roles of the Assembly.
Ugandan legislators have also decried non-remittance of contributions from partner states, which makes it difficult for the East African Community activities to run. Out of the 7 countries, only 4 countries have no arrears.
For a long time, defaulted on payment of their, you know, of their contributions to the EAC. For example, up to now, the South Sudan is indebted to the community.
Yesterday, the budget was retabled and passed by the East African Legislative Assembly again on a sitting that was held via online. It remains to be seen whether all partner states will assent to it. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.